It's time once again for That Business Show with Jamie and Kelly. That Business Show gives a voice to Tampa Bay's entrepreneurial community and highlights our community leaders, aiming to inspire and educate our listeners. Become a part of the entrepreneurial movement today by becoming a member of the Tampa Bay Business Owners and get your brand on air today. Visit TampaBayRadio.com for more information. All shows available on demand. Now, here are your hosts, Jamie and Kelly.
Hey, good morning, everybody, and welcome to That Business Show with Jamie and Kelly, where business becomes show business. We're here Monday through Friday, 7 a.m. to 9 a.m. on Tampa Bay's 1250 Winds, WHNZ, and then we're repurposed across multiple podcasting platforms. So if you're finding us across the country or even in another land across the seas, we thank you for listening. We're finding that the audience is expanding more and more so each and every week through the use of different podcasting sites. So if you're listening on that medium, we definitely appreciate that. And you can, again, find us on iTunes, Google Play, Stitcher, Spreaker, a lot of different podcasting platforms out there, is that the medium is becoming more and more popular these days, in addition to the old terrestrial radio. So again, thank you to all of our listeners. Kelly Wilson joins us in studio, owner of the Edge Business Community and the Edge Business Magazine. So Kelly, good morning to you.
Good morning. Happy Tuesday.
Thank you so much. And how was the holiday weekend?
It was uneventful, like always, but I'm on a mission this year. I need eventful.
You need eventful.
I need even, instead of uneventful. You know, every week we come in, oh, uneventful. Part of my one of my New Year, you know, normally there's New Year resolutions, and I do New Year intentions, but one of my New Year must-haves is so it's a mixture between intention and resolution, but is to have balance in my life.
That's not possible for entrepreneurs.
I'm determined to try to find balance of some kind.
Once we do find balance, we find something else to screw up the balance. That's just the way it goes.
I'm optimistic. I'm going to be optimistic this year and hope that I can find some kind of balance. So I'm working on it. Because one day we're going to walk in here and you're going to say, how was your weekend? I'm going to say, oh my God. It was amazing. Totally eventful.
And again, you find her magazine over at thatbusinessmagazine.com. You can subscribe to it, $38 for six issues annually, and we can get a free copy of the fall winter edition again over at thatbusinessmagazine.com, featuring Terry Blachek of Orange Theory Fitness on the cover, and a lot of good articles on several different topics, including healthcare and also the history of Orange Theory Fitness, which we've covered on the program several times. And again, thatbusinessmagazine.com, and pick up a copy of that electronically for free. So we're going to be talking with Corey Ellison in this segment of the program. He is the director of operations with EWI Construction, a local contracting firm that's done a number of great jobs in and around the Tampa Bay area, including the Oxford Exchange. So let's welcome in Corey Ellison this morning. Corey, good morning to you.
Morning.
Welcome. Good morning.
And he's his brother's been on the show a few times, so people that are familiar with the show may know Casey Ellison. And I tell you, two look identical, by the way. I mean, you often get mistaken for one another out there?
We do. There's a lot of, you'll walk into a meeting and they'll kind of look at you and say, I think I know you. You know me. You probably know my brother. So it happens pretty regularly.
Who's the older of you two there?
Casey's the older.
Casey's the older one. Was he the typical older brother, you know, kind of pushing you around a little bit, or did you all kind of click at a young age?
No, he was a typical older brother. It wasn't just him. It was his friends. A good day in my life was the day I realized I was faster than him.
How many years apart were you two?
We're just shy of 7 years apart.
7 years apart. Yep. My brother were 6 years apart, and I think that age range right there kind of, you know, feeds the differences, I mean, feeds the kind of the animosity between the brothers, because when you're closer, you can become more friends. But that you're kind of in different generations when you're 6 and 7 years. And I can remember my brother wanting to follow me around and do this and, you know, watch me play video games and go out with my friends. I didn't want him there, you know. Yeah. It was awkward and everything. And so was that kind of your relationship with him?
I'm sure I was the annoying little brother at some point, yeah.
And he always would want to, you know, watch me play video games and everything. I would chase him away and everything. And so, but, you know, now we gotten older and everything, you know, we get along. He started to work for me for some time, but even when he worked for me, we would still butt heads and everything. So who runs the show these days? You were
Well, you said you run faster, right? So yeah, you can outrun him.
You know, I run the day-to-day operations. Casey's our CEO, so he's kind of the, you know, he's the guy out there finding work. He's the guy out there, you know, kind of
making it happen.
Yeah, he's that guy. I'm the guy herding the cats, making sure everybody's getting everything done that they need to get done, and keeping everything on track, and making sure the machines the machine's running and it's running right.
I was gonna say, what kind of machines? Like, what do you mean, machines in general? The business running as a machine.
I'm just like, we're a general contractor, essentially, you know, construction management.
Okay. They've done a number of great projects in and around the community, and you're also involved with now the armature building over there off of off the river and everything. So let's start with that. Tell us a little bit about what's going on over there and what that's going to turn into.
Yeah, that's a great, great project. It's the guys over at Soho Capital. They've kind of pieced together over the years about 40 acres over there on the river. I think the kind of the centerpiece of that development is the Tampa Armature Works building.
What was that building before? What was Armature Works?
It was a few different things. Probably most notably, it was the old trolley barns. So that's where they'd bring the trolleys in, work on them. I mean, they had there. We found them during construction. These huge concrete, essentially mechanics pits where they could bring the trolleys in on tracks, work on them. And move them throughout, you know, they paint them, you know, all the general maintenance on it.
And how long has that building sat there kind of unattended? I know we did an event there, a real estate gathering, probably 7 or 8 years ago, and it was just kind of dilapidated and run down. It had parts of it that were fixed up and were nice. I remember there's some shops in there. But, you know, how long has that thing kind of just sat there kind of unattended?
You know, surprisingly, it was being utilized until the early 90s, but time wasn't. As soon as it was no longer an active building, time was not kind to it,
right?
For sure.
And I can remember we took a boat out on the river off of off the Armitage building right there. I don't know if they're still doing that over there, but I can remember doing that several years ago. Do they do that over there right now, or is it all shut down for the for the construction?
Yeah, it's all shut down. They are bringing in – there will be a marina there, so, or some wet slips, so you will be able to enjoy it by boat once again once we're all – we're all done out there. So
what is it going to turn into? What is the plan of the building?
So the armature building itself is going to be a mixture of things. Probably most notably, it's going to be a market hall, kind of like Ponce City Market in Atlanta.
Okay.
You know, almost like Eataly, except it's a little different than Eataly in that there's individual owners. But there'll be 16 market stalls within the Armature Works building, which will have 16 different restaurants or... there's, you know, Metropolitan Ministries will be in there. They're gonna have a community garden and a grocery, and you know, you've got some restaurants from around town like Ava and
Ava's gonna open a second location over there.
They're gonna have a you know, these, they're just, think about it almost like a really like a culinary food court. So Ava will have a small, you know, it's like 300-400 square feet, and you know, they'll have a limited menu, but in, I think a lot of these guys from talking to them are going to use it kind of more as a experimental type deal. They'll have their staples, but I think you'll see a lot more kind of, you know, new food, different food.
Yeah, I remember growing up in Indianapolis when I was a kid, and there was a place downtown called the City Market, and it was like the coolest place. If I ever was going there for anything, it was just the coolest place to go. It sounds a lot like what you're talking about.
Yeah, it's very similar, yeah.
Yeah, there were all these different, some restaurants, but then just other local, I don't even know what you'd call it, delis, but not really delis. They were just like, seemed like authentic, like, you know.
Cafe.
It was just, yeah, I guess. Neat place, though.
Yeah, I mean, there's going to be a legit, like, real deal butcher there. I mean, where you can actually go and get the real thing. So
where is this building at? Because I'm not familiar. I've heard about it.
It's in the Heights. It's down on the Hillsborough River.
Okay.
Like kind of like Palm Avenue.
Seminole Tampa Heights area. A booming area, by the way, in real estate.
Yeah.
Whenever I'm talking real estate.
So I mean, near that, the fire station, I'm thinking.
Yeah. In that general, a little bit more north of that.
On
you know
Florida.
Where, you know where Eulalie is?
Yeah, mm-hmm. Okay.
It's just down, just around the bend of the river from Eulalie.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and in a very happening area over there. A lot of great opportunities in real estate. So if you're in the investing spectrum over there, a lot of good things are happening over there.
So when is that supposed to be finished?
We're shooting for... Probably a mid-May open date for the market hall, and then in addition to the market hall, you have there'll be two restaurants, a full-blown restaurant, a rooftop bar. There's a beautiful event space, an extremely large event space, and they have a smaller, more intimate space. And then there will be some work share offices as well.
Oh, so just in a few months then, in May.
Yeah, it's coming.
Wow, that's exciting.
What else is EWI Construction involved in right now? Has that got your full attention, or do you have your hands in other projects around Tampa Bay right now?
Yeah, you know, the guys over there at Soho Capital that are doing that development, they got us busy because we're right across the street on the other side of Palm doing the Pearl over there, which is a 314-unit apartment complex. Huge building. It will be big for that area as well.
What's the name of that one again?
It's called the Pearl.
The Pearl, and have 314 units coming over there. What type of units are these going to be? Are these going to be basic 800, 1,000 square foot units? Are they going to be luxury? What are you?
You're gonna have a mix. They've got everything from a one bedroom all the way up to a two and three bedroom. I mean, I think they envision not just young professionals. I think they envision families living down there as well.
Yeah, there's so much happening in that area. We talked with the brewery lady last week with three daughters, but we kind of got off on the topic of we're talking with Brewbus. That's right, Brewbus that's over there right now. And there's these craft breweries that are popping up over there, and the Brewbus that takes you around to the different locations. It's starting to kind of get a flare over there.
Yeah, just up the block, you have Hidden Springs Brewery right there on Franklin Street now, right there by the Rialto Theater.
Yeah, Seminole Heights, Tampa Heights, starting to become known as a craft brewery destination. Tampa kind of getting that feel for that right now. And the Brewbus is one place you can stop in, have some beer, and then get on the bus. And you can even drink on the bus too, if I remember right.
Yeah, craft beer and food is what's going on down there right now, for sure.
Inside the Armature building, is there going to be bars also? You said 16 different
restaurants.
There will be a
cocktail bar called Fine and Dandy that will be craft cocktails, mixologists, that kind of cool vibe.
Now, if I remember right, EWI Construction opened, 2007, am I correct?
Yeah, we're going in the year 10.
And you've done a lot of work in the downtown area. How have you all been able to get these jobs, these contracts? Because so many contractors struggled, especially 2007. That wasn't a good year for, contractors.
No. The company started about in the worst possible time it could have, but we managed to grow every year. I think a big part of it is, to be honest with you, our youth. We're a little younger than most, especially at the top with Casey and Anthony, the founding partners of the company. I think that a lot of the newer kind of trendier places, I think the owners identify with us a little bit more. We're very design oriented for a contractor. We appreciate good design. When we're going through the pricing and building a project, one thing that always happens on every construction project is, and it's a four-letter word for architects, is value engineering. Mm-hmm. So, when we get a price in, we do everything we can to value engineer for our client, but we also do everything we can to protect the design for the architect. And I think that's something that's kind of rang true with all of our projects, and I think it's a big reason as to why we were able to grow and be involved in all these great projects like Oxford Exchange and AVA and... we just finished up, I don't know if you guys have been out there, Ocosina. It's kind of a...
No, where's that at?
It's over off Henderson.
I haven't been there yet, but I heard that name, sorry.
It's an awesome, kind of true, authentic Mexican restaurant. It's a little more elevated. It's not Tex-Mex. It's true Mexican, but the design's beautiful. It's a really, really cool place.
What was the first first job, I would say, that you got in 2007? What was that first big break that y'all got?
We started the company on a big custom home. I mean, that's how we started. That's when they brought, I graduated from Florida State with a real estate degree in 2006, early seven, which it's about as bad of a time to graduate with a real estate degree as you can get.
Yeah, that was pretty tough.
Yeah. So
and you started out in the custom home business.
We did. So they needed a superintendent. I grew up in the construction industry. My father ran Beck here for years and years and years. And, even though I said I was going to avoid it like the plague growing up, found my way right back to it.
Into the family business.
Yeah, the guys asked me if I could run that project for them while I was looking for jobs, and here we are 10 years later.
Hold that thought there. We got to take a break. Currently talking to Corey Allison, Director of Operations with EWI Construction. Again, they have worked on a lot of the great projects in downtown Tampa, including Oxford Exchange and AVA, and we'll talk with them about some of the other stuff that's up on the horizon when we come back from the break on That Business Show with Jamie and Kelly, where business becomes show business.
What's up, business rock stars? Are you ready to bring out the CEO in you? Join Julianne Nichols, CEO of Focus on You Strategy, every other Friday on That Business Show.
She'll be talking with other chief entrepreneurial officers about how they grew their businesses. Remember, you could join the conversation at Focus on You Strategies Focus Fridays Facebook group at facebook.com/groups/Focus Fridays. That's facebook.com/groups/Focus Fridays. Be the CEO of you. Did you know the biggest challenge business leaders face today is creating an engaged and productive workforce culture? Bill Meyer Ham Consulting wants to help you solve this challenge. They will help you transform your workforce culture to produce amazing business results. Call Bill Meyer Ham Consulting at 941-201-4650 today or visit BillMeyerHam.com. That's BillMeyerHam.com. Have a conversation.
Have you ever tried to buy a home for your family only to find out that you don't qualify for a mortgage loan? You thought that after 20 years as a customer of your bank, they would help you when you needed it the most, right? Unfortunately, the banks of today are not the banks of our parents and grandparents, and our relationships with them just don't matter anymore. My name is Frank Cotto, and I'm the president of the Lincoln Lending Group. We all may need a bank, but we also need a Frank, and that's what I'm here to do for you today. Lincoln Lending Group will waive all of your lending fees, which include your mortgage, application fee, your underwriting fee, processing fees, and any bank points. Just call 813-MORTGAGE. You drop the E, and we'll drop the fee.
Savvy business owners utilize technology to connect with customers, communicate among teams, and collaborate with partners. Even with advances in technology, you all know it's not infallible. Where do you turn when your technology starts working against you? Who do you depend on to keep your team productive? Don't wait until your technology fails you. Get ahead of the crisis and contact the professionals at Alpha Computing Solutions so they can show you how to keep your technology running smoothly. Visit them online at www.alphacomputing.com.
If you've been following That Business Show on Facebook and Twitter, you may have noticed the quality of some of our images. That's because one of our sponsors is pro photographer Rick Tosseda, a member of the Professional Photographers of America. You can view his extensive work by going to his website at ricktosseda.com or call him for an appointment to chat about your photography needs at 813-641-4757. That's 813-641-4757. Rick Tosseda Visuals. Call him for your next event or project. Teresa Turner is a certified public accountant and the founder of Tax Happens, a boutique-style CPA firm providing small businesses and individuals with hands-on, personalized tax and accounting services. Although we would love to tell you how happy their clients are, we would like you to see for yourself. Tax Happens has 21 Google reviews and a 4.8-star Google rating, 17 Yelp reviews and a 5-star Yelp rating, 38 Facebook reviews and a 4.9-star Facebook rating. What sets Tax Happens apart is number 1, upfront pricing, 2, clear deadlines, 3, personally available year-round, and number 4, a willingness to empower clients to do as much or as little as they desire. Visit taxhappens.com for more information. At Vane 911, we will help you feel great again. Do you have restless legs, night leg cramps, or ankle swelling? Restless legs, cramping, swelling, and tired heavy legs are often symptoms of hidden vein disease. You do not have to have visible bulging veins to have the symptoms of vein disease. The vein care specialists at Vane 911 are uniquely qualified to evaluate and treat your veins. Are you unhappy with your previous vein treatment? Vane 911 succeeds where others fail. Call Vane 911 today at 855-VANE-911. That's 855-834-6911 to book your free consultation. Vane 911. We will help you feel great again.
From the Florida Central Auto Loans Traffic Center.
Crash in Tampa at the intersection of Hillsboro and Habana. Left lane eastbound affected here. Also, the southbound lanes of Habana being affected. Southbound 75 slow south of Brusby Downs to around I-4. Southbound 275 very slow between Fletcher Avenue and Hillsboro. And earlier crashes along U.S. 19 anywhere between State Road 580 and Nebraska now clear. See traffic problems. Call the injury firm of Abrahamson and Uderick. Hillsboro traffic tip line 866-545-9595.
This report is brought to you by Lead Safe America. Does your child struggle to concentrate and pay attention? What looks like ADD or autism may actually be caused by lead poisoning. Lead is a neurotoxin. It can cause permanent brain damage. Find out how to protect your family. Go to LeadSafeAmerica.org.
Today, patchy fog in the morning, then partly cloudy in the afternoon with a high of 80. Tonight, patchy fog again with a low 63. Tomorrow, a mix of sun and clouds with a high 80.
You're listening to That Business Show with Jamie and Kelly on 1250 Winds WHNZ. Miss the show? Then head over to TampaBayRadio.com, where all shows are available on demand. Once again, here are your hosts, Jamie and Kelly.
Hey, welcome back to That Business Show with Jamie and Kelly, where business becomes show business. Talking to Corey Ellison, Director of Operations with EWI Construction. Learn more at ewiconstruction.com. And so, Corey, what's out there on the horizon for EWI Construction? You're involved with the armature building. You're involved with the development, the Pearl. Are those two things got you busy for now and nothing else on the horizon? You all got our stuff in the works?
No, we actually, which I think ties in great with your show, is we're starting in March. We're doing a building for Junior Achievement. I don't know if you're familiar with their program out there.
No.
So we're doing their new Biz Park, but they do or we're doing Finance Park. They have Biz Park, where they take elementary age kids out and they teach them kind of what it's like to run a household, checking accounts, all that stuff. And this is a new building that we're starting in March that kind of builds on that for the middle school age kids.
So it's a financial education center of sorts?
Yeah, exactly, okay. Exactly.
Yeah, I've been through the younger one, the one that's already there. But like the field trips, the schools in the area go on field trips there, right? Yeah, so I've been, I remember with my daughter, I don't remember so much.
How do the programs work? Didn't they do just something for the day or something?
Yeah, you spend the day there and they go and they get money from the bank and then they go and they each have jobs. And, you know, it's like the day they get to like live the life of an adult. It's kind of, they have to spend so much money and they get the paychecks.
Yeah, they have all different jobs. You know, they even have radio DJ.
They do.
That's cool. Because I've always advocated, you know, on this program for, you know, we need a, you know, like a financial literacy program for schools or for children in our school system.
Well, actually, the gentleman that was here earlier on, who was that with the early education?
Oh, yes. I know what you're talking about. I can't remember his name.
Yeah, well, we were talking the same thing we were talking about. I always forget the name of the building.
Dr. Noble and everything was talking about
with
that.
Early
yes.
childhood
yeah,
education early we were childhood. Talking about. What is the facility called there?
It's called, that's Biz Park, and we're building Finance Park, but the actual foundation is called Junior Achievement. They're a private national charity. They provide the service to our Hillsborough County schools and Pinellas schools, and it's no cost to them.
Yeah, he did. Well, and you know, it's one thing. I guess I look back on it, and I'm excited now. My daughter's 16 and is a junior, and you can hardly tell her much. You know, she's pretty much grown. But I'm so happy that I invested the time and went as like the chaperones and did the different things when they were younger, because you know it goes so fast, and it's important for us parents like to know what opportunities are out there for them, or what our children are experiencing, or you know, and then how can we zone in on that?
Yeah,
and
absolutely.
You know, help them engage the learning process.
So, from a contractor standpoint, since 2007, you know, how's the Tampa marketplace looking right now for development?
It's going strong right now. It's definitely picked up. I think everybody's cranking. I know we're busy. I know a lot of our fellow contractors are busy. I just hope that it sustains.
So no more custom homes, strictly developments, or do you go back into the custom home business?
You know,
as well?
we do one or two a year, just kind of like that's kind of what got us here.
How long do most of the projects take that you work on?
I would say commercially 6 to 8 months is kind of the typical.
What was the market that you're working on? Like, what was the time length for that? If you're going to finish up in May, when
it's going to be in that, it's going to
really?
Be in that 8 month range.
You think it would take a lot longer than that to put together those type of buildings?
The commercial projects go a lot quicker. It's the homes that are 12, 14 month build schedules.
No,
well, why is that?
It's the design.
Oh,
it's the high design. It's the mill. It's the cabinetry. It's there's
a
the
lot change
more.
Orders.
Yeah,
the
yeah.
Change orders they hit you with.
There's a lot more. The pieces that go into a residential project than a commercial, actually.
Where's the new Junior Achievement building going?
It's going over off of MLK.
Okay. Is that over near where the other one
yep,
was?
Yep, it's going right next to the other one.
All right.
That's good. Exciting.
Corey Ellison, Director of Operations with EWI Construction. Thank you so much for what you're doing for our community.
Thank you. Thanks for having me.
All right. And again, learn more about them, ewiconstruction.com. Learn more about us at tampabayradio.com, and also all shows available on demand over at thatbusinessshow.com. And get tickets for the award show next Monday at tampabayradio.com as well. You've been listening to That Business Show, Jamie and Kelly, where business becomes show business.
Hi, I'm Kelly Hamm from Dillmeyer Hamm Consulting. Did you know that one of the biggest challenges that leaders face is getting their employees to be engaged, motivated, and producing amazing business results? At Dillmeyer Hamm Consulting, we'll help you transform your workforce culture from one that might be underperforming, maybe mediocre, to achieving amazing business results. You see, we realize that your workforce culture is equally as important as your business plan and your business strategy. The two must be aligned in order for you to reach your desired business and financial goals.
Hey, Carol.
Hey, Jim.
I just got this plan that could really help with our process here.
Okay, why don't you just have a seat and let's go over it.
Let us help you transform your workforce culture by leveraging your most important assets, your people. I want to know what's going on in your organization. Let us help you transform your workforce culture. Let's have a conversation.
I feel guilty that I can't always be there when Mom feels stuck at home. She was always there for us. But now she can't get out, and I'm not always available to take her places. Someone else needs to help her get around. Then I learned about Home Instead. Now Mom can do what she enjoys because her personal caregiver is there, and I can just be a daughter again.
Are you struggling to care for your loved one? We can help. Home Instead Senior Care. To us, it's personal.
Hampson and Uterick, Hillsboro Traffic Tip Line, 866-545-9595.
This report is brought to you by Lead Safe America. Do you live in a historic home? Are you renovating? Your children could be at risk of lead poisoning. It takes just a microscopic amount of lead dust to poison a child. Learn more at leadsafeamerica.org.
1250 Winds Weather Center forecast. Unseasonably warm today. We'll see those temperatures back up around 80 degrees. Partly cloudy skies, low 60s tonight. Next few days, forecast remaining the same. Look for some rain on Friday and a little cooler temps into the weekend. Impact Radio, 1250 Winds, WHNZ.
You're listening to That Business Show with Jamie and Kelly on 1250 Winds WHNZ. Miss the show? Then head over to TampaBayRadio.com where all shows are available on demand. Once again, here are your hosts, Jamie and Kelly.
And welcome to That Business Show with Jamie and Kelly, where business becomes show business. We're here Monday through Friday, 7 a.m. to 9 a.m. on Tampa Bay's 1250 Winds WHNZ, looking to inspire entrepreneurship and talk by talking to different community and business leaders from around the Tampa Bay region and also sometimes outside of the community as well, as our next guest is. He is Jonah Berger. He is a marketing professor at the Wharton School at the University of Pennsylvania, and he has published dozens of articles in top-tier academic journals, and his work has appeared in the New York Times, the Wall Street Journal, the Washington Post, and a number of other locations as well. And he's also the author of two well-known books, Contagious, Why Things Catch On, and also Invisible Influence, The Hidden Forces That Shape Behavior. So, Jonah, welcome into the program today.
Good morning.
Thanks so much for having me.
And so you're an expert on social influence, and I'm always interested in this because this really comes down to the follower versus leader discussion that I like to have sometimes. And so first off, just tell us a little bit more about you and what social influence means to you.
Sure. So in my day job, I'm a marketing professor at the Wharton School, and I do a lot of research on social influence, word of mouth, and why products, ideas, and behaviors catch on. And, you know, I think what's most interesting about this space is when we look at our own behavior, whether it's a small decision we're making, like what breakfast cereal to buy, or a big decision to make, like who to hire or which house to buy, we think we're making our own decisions. We think our preferences, our attitudes, our likes, our dislikes are driving what we do. But actually, other people are making our decisions for us. There are other people around us, whether they're our friends and family members, or even people that we don't know, and a stranger who's running on a treadmill at the gym or someone else we see at the office. These individuals can have a surprising and often subtle impact on our behavior. And so it's about understanding these impacts and then understanding how we can use these tools to be more influential and get our own products and ideas to catch on.
Are leaders just as influenced by social influence as a follower? I'd like to think that, leaders are more independent. They go about making their decisions more based on independent thought. How would you advise when asked that question?
You know, we all like to think of ourselves as independent. It was funny. I was telling a friend of mine about the recent book I had coming out and telling him how it was about social influence. And he was lamenting the effect of social influence on his peers. He's a lawyer in Washington, D.C., and he was saying, God, all D.C. lawyers are the same.
You know, they make partner, they make it big, and the first thing they do is they buy a BMW.
They're predictable.
They're predictable. And I said, well, that's interesting, but, you know, don't you drive a BMW? And he said, oh, yeah, but they all drive gray ones, and I drive a blue one. And what I thought was really interesting about his story is, you know, we do see influence in the world around us. Whether a leader or a follower, we see influence. We see other people listening to the same music. We see other people making the same decisions. In fact, the only place we don't seem to see influence is ourselves. We see it in the world around us, but whether we're a leader or a follower, we're often subtly influenced by the folks around us. And so the question is, you know, how can we better understand those influences? And after we understand them, how can we take advantage of them?
So how can an entrepreneur who has a product, you know, get their product to, you know, catch on, as you write about in your book, Contagious? How do you get, you know, that influence?
How can we be influencers?
Yeah, how can we be influencers and get people to buy our products?
Yeah, this is a great and really important question, and I think we often think it's one of two answers. It's either advertising, we have to have a big advertising budget, and advertising certainly helps, or, you know, it's about price and quality. We have to have a really cheap price and a really high quality. But it turns out if you look at why things catch on, there's one common denominator that all these things have, whether it's online content, a product, a service, or idea. It's often word of mouth that drives behavior. In fact, a dollar spent on word of mouth goes 10 times as far as a dollar spent on traditional advertising. And so the question then is, well, what drives word of mouth? Why do people talk about some things rather than others? And when we look at these things, we often think it's random or luck or chance, right? Why some piece of content goes viral on the internet, or why some product or movie or idea seems to catch on. But it's not random and it's not luck. There's really a science behind it. We, with great colleagues, I've spent the last 15 years studying this area. We've looked at thousands of pieces of online content, looking at what makes online content viral. We've looked at tens of thousands of brands, and we've looked at millions of purchases across the United States and the world. And we see again and again the same six factors come up. And in Contagious, I put them in a framework called the STEPPS framework, and that stands for social currency, triggers, emotion, public, practical value, and stories. And each of these principles is a driver of word of mouth. It drives products and ideas to catch on. And by understanding them, we can craft contagious content and we can make our stuff more successful.
Can you repeat that again? What were the steps? That was great.
Sure.
Advice.
It's social currency, triggers, emotion, public, practical value, and stories. And in case it's helpful, I'll give an example of just one of them. So, you know, let's take social currency, the first one in the framework. The very simple idea there is the better something makes people look, the more likely they are to talk about it and share it. For example, I tell a great story in the book of a bar in New York City called Please Don't Tell, that's actually hidden inside a hot dog restaurant. So you walk in what looks like a hot dog restaurant. They got a great menu, but off to the side is a little phone booth. You walk in the phone booth. There's a rotary dial phone. You put your finger in one of the numbers. You go around in a circle, and they'll ask you if you have a reservation. And if you do, back of the phone will be open. It's a secret entrance, and you'll be led into this bar called Please Don't Tell. This bar's never advertised, yet they're full every day, and it's not lack of competition. Dozens of bars in New York City in the same area. So how'd they cut through the clutter? And what they did really interestingly is they made themselves a secret. And if you think about it, there's a very simple secret about secrets.
Everybody wants what they can't have.
Yeah, everybody wants what they can't have, but also secrets make us look good, right? If you think about the last time someone told you something and they told you not to tell anyone else, one of the first things you probably did is you probably told someone. Why? Because you know telling someone else that secret will make you look good. And so too often, right, as marketers or, you know, entrepreneurs, we think about how do we look, right? Do people like our product? Do they like our idea? Well, hold on. How do they look when they talk about our product or idea? Because the better we can make them look, the more social currency we can give them, the more likely they'll be to share our message, and the more likely our message will be to catch on.
Now, I always think, you know, to get noticed, you got to have some type of differentiating factor. You got to be different in some way. Would you advise that that's, something that is needed in a product? You got to be different in some way from your competitors, or can you stand out and without being different?
You know, I think being different is a good way to stand out, but I think there's an important caveat there. It's not just being different. It's about being able to communicate different. There's a great video that I talk about in Contagious where a guy sticks an iPhone in a blender. So imagine dropping an iPhone in a blender, turning on, the smoothie setting and watching it go quickly. And about 30 seconds go by, the iPhone is turned into dust. There's just a metal piece on the outside. The rest of it is turned into dust. Eye smoke, a little black smoke comes out when he opens up the top. It's a series of videos called Will It Blend from this company called Blendtec. They blend all sorts of things. They blend iPhones, they blend golf balls, they blend Blick lighters, and it's a great display. These videos have millions of views, and sales have gone up hundreds of percent, but it's a great display of how powerful the blender is. Right? It shows you by watching this video, if the blender is tough enough to cut through an iPhone, it has to be a really powerful blender. And this comes back to your point about differentiation. Is that blender the only blender that could cut through an iPhone? I don't actually know. As a viewer, I'm not a blender expert. I don't know. But what I do know is this is the only blender company that showed people that they could do that. And so that's really the question. It's not just about being different or being the same. It's about how can you show your consumer or customer your point of differentiation, your value proposition. Not just tell them, but show them in a remarkable way so they see how valuable you are. Maybe the competitor can do the same thing, but if your competitor can't communicate it clearly, and you can, you'll get that customer.
Elaborate on the point of emotion, because I struggle with this a lot of times, because I want to provide the people practical use of my products and my services, but so often I'm told, Jamie, people don't buy because they need some. A lot of times they buy based on emotion, and I have a hard time drumming up emotion sometimes or reaching out to somebody's emotional side. How would you advise somebody?
I think as good marketers, again, we want to focus on the features of our product. We want to say, these are the five reasons you should buy my product. These are the six aspects of my service that make me so valuable. But customers don't care so much about features. They care about benefits. They care about what's relevant to them, what's important to them. And so more than focusing on function, we need to focus on feelings, right? Why might someone like this particular thing? How does it fit into their lives? What about this thing is going to make them excited and fired up and really want to build loyalty with a brand? Too often, if we're competing on function, well, some competitor can just come in and offer the same thing. We say we offer a low price. Well, a competitor comes in and offers a lower price, and we've lost that customer. Whereas if we can build loyalty, if we can create an emotional connection, that customer is much more likely to stay with us over time. And in fact, the same thing plays out when we look at why people share things. We looked at thousands of pieces of online content, news, for example, looking at why people share news. And in addition to measuring how useful the information was and where it was featured and who wrote it, we also measured how much emotion that news contained. And what we found is more emotional news was more likely to be shared. But it wasn't just about positive and negative. It wasn't that people share positive things and they avoid sharing negative things. It was a little more nuanced than that. There were certain negative emotions, for example, that increased sharing, but other negative emotions that decreased sharing. Anger and anxiety, for example, increase sharing. The more angry or anxious someone feels after reading an article, the more likely they are to share it. But the more sad they feel, the less likely they are to share it. And it turns out it's not just about positive or negative. It's about high arousal. And when we feel angry, when we feel anxious, we get fired up. We want to take action. Same thing when we're laughing or we're excited or we're inspired. Whereas if we're content, we're not fired up to take that action. And so it's all about evoking the right emotions and getting that to get people to share our stuff.
So what drew you into the field of social influence? I know you've done a number of studies. You obviously, very intelligent. You speak at the you're a professor at the Wharton School at the University of Pennsylvania. What drew you into the field of academics with this?
I think what's so interesting is we all see these puzzles around us all the time. We've all gotten something on social media. We go, why did that go viral, right? What about that made people share it? Or we've all seen products or services, movies that we didn't think were very good, but are the talk of the town, or a local entrepreneur that's really made it big. And we see these things and wonder, well, why is that? How does that work? And I've been lucky to get a chance to peel back the curtain a little bit and actually get to quantitatively study this. And, we're not perfect. We're not done. Since these books have come out, we've done dozens of more studies. We're still learning more and more every day, but it's an exciting area to get to understand why people do what they do and how we can harness these tools for good, right? Because just like not-so-good products catch on, we can use these messages to help good initiatives spread within the community or change our kids' behavior at school. And so if we understand how the science works, we can harness social influence power, and we can use it to help good things succeed.
Hold on the phone, Jonah. I got to take a break here, but when we come back from the break, he's going to share with us an interesting study about how even cockroaches are influenced and how that carries over to us as a human. So I'll have him share that story
this
when we come back from the break. Again, we're speaking to Jonah Berger. He is a marketing professor at the Wharton School at the University of Pennsylvania and author of two well-known books, Contagious, Why Things Catch On, and also Invisible Influence, The Hidden Forces That Shape Behavior. And we'll put some links up in the show recap to where you can find those books as well. You're listening to That Business Show with Jamie and Kelly, where business becomes show business. In an age when the good and the better vie for attention, it is the best that stands out. The Best of Tampa Bay from proudly Florida is the love story for the city of Tampa, celebrating success, sharing achievements, a tribute to enterprise and community spirit. Let proudly Florida showcase your business to your city, your nation, and the world. For more information, email info@proudlyflorida.com and be sure to visit proudlyflorida.com. If you've been following That Business Show on Facebook and Twitter, you may have noticed the quality of some of our images. That's because one of our sponsors is pro photographer Rick Taseda, a member of the Professional Photographers of America. You can view his extensive work by going to his website at ricktaseda.com or call him for an appointment to chat about your photography needs at 813-641-4757. That's 813-641-4757. Rick Taseda Visuals. Call him for your next event or project. Teresa Turner is a certified public accountant and the founder of Tax Happens, a boutique-style CPA firm providing small businesses and individuals with hands-on, personalized tax and accounting services. Although we would love to tell you how happy their clients are, we would like you to see for yourself. Tax Happens has 21 Google reviews and a 4.8-star Google rating, 17 Yelp reviews and a 5-star Yelp rating, 38 Facebook reviews and a 4.9-star Facebook rating. What sets Tax Happens apart is, number one, upfront pricing, two, clear deadlines, three, personally available year-round, and number four, a willingness to empower clients to do as much or as little as they desire. Visit taxhappens.com for more information. At Vane 911, we will help you feel great again. Do you have restless legs, night leg cramps, or ankle swelling? Restless legs, cramping, swelling, and tired heavy legs are often symptoms of hidden vein disease. You do not have to have visible bulging veins to have the symptoms of vein disease. The vein care specialists at Vane 911 are uniquely qualified to evaluate and treat your veins. Are you unhappy with your previous vein treatment? Vane 911 succeeds where others fail. Call Vane 911 today at 855-VANE-911. That's 855-834-6911 to book your free consultation. Vane 911. We will help you feel great again.
Did you know the biggest challenge business leaders face today is creating an engaged and productive workforce culture? Bill Meyer Ham Consulting wants to help you solve this challenge. They will help you transform your workforce culture to produce amazing business results. Call Bill Meyer Ham Consulting at 941-201-4650 today or visit BillMeyerHam.com. That's BillMeyerHam.com. Have a conversation.
Have you ever tried to buy a home for your family only to find out that you don't qualify for a mortgage loan? You thought that after 20 years as a customer of your bank, they would help you when you needed it the most, right? Unfortunately, the banks of today are not the banks of our parents and grandparents, and our relationships with them just don't matter anymore. My name is Frank Cotto, and I'm the president of the Lincoln Lending Group. We all may need a bank, but we also need a Frank, and that's what I'm here to do for you today. Lincoln Lending Group will waive all of your lending fees, which include your mortgage, application fee, your underwriting fee, processing fees, and any bank points. Just call 813-MORTGAGE. You drop the E, and we'll drop the fee.
Savvy business owners utilize technology to connect with customers, communicate among teams, and collaborate with partners. Even with advances in technology, you all know it's not infallible. Where do you turn when your technology starts working against you? Who do you depend on to keep your team productive? Don't wait until your technology fails you. Get ahead of the crisis and contact the professionals at Alpha Computing Solutions so they can show you how to keep your technology running smoothly. Visit them online at www.alphacomputing.com.
Serious crash in Largo on southbound Missouri Avenue approaching East Bay, and the right two lanes are blocked here. Avoid this area if you can. Also, slow traffic still on southbound 275 between Fletcher Avenue and Sly. Southbound Veterans Expressway very slow between Hillsborough Avenue and the Courtney Campbell Causeway. See traffic problems? Call the injury firm of Abrahamson and Uderick. Hillsborough traffic tip line 866-545-9595.
This report is brought to you by the Foundation for a Better Life.
While many rose up with violence, he sat down for peace. Mahatma Gandhi reached out with the strength he cultivated within his soul. So, pass it on from the Foundation for a Better Life at values.com.
Today, patchy fog in the morning, then partly cloudy in the afternoon with a high of 80. Tonight, patchy fog again with a low 63. Tomorrow, a mix of sun and clouds with a high 80.
You're listening to That Business Show with Jamie and Kelly on 1250 Winds WHNZ. Miss the show? Then head over to TampaBayRadio.com, where all shows are available on demand. Once again, here are your hosts, Jamie and Kelly.
And welcome back to That Business Show with Jamie and Kelly, where business becomes show business. Talking about social influence with Jonah Berger. He is a marketing professor with the Wharton School of the University of Pennsylvania. And Jonah, I was listening to you on another program, and you're talking about how even cockroaches are influenced. But it also has to do with, you know, the complication of the task, whether it's a, you know, menial task or a complicated task, and how people watching also impact us. So share with us this study.
Sure. So one of the best ways to use social influence is to motivate ourselves and others. It can be a powerful motivating tool. But the question is, are others motivating or demotivating, right? Do others get us to work harder or lead us to work less? And so this original study was done hundreds of years ago. They actually looked at cyclists, and they found that cyclists biking around a track biked faster when other cyclists were biking with them. And since then, dozens of studies have shown the same thing, that people and animals work harder when other folks are around. So, you know, if you're tying your shoelaces, for example, you tie them faster when other people are around. Or dogs eat faster, or other animals work harder when other animals are around. But there are some other studies that have shown the exact opposite, that actually people work less when others are around. So, or we do things worse. So if you've ever parallel parked, for example, you probably notice that you have a harder time parallel parking. You don't park faster, but you actually park slower when someone else is in the car. Or if you ever tried to tie a bow tie, for example, something you're not very good at, and other people are watching you, somehow it seems harder and it takes much longer to do. So when do others lead us to work faster and better, and when do others lead us to work slower and not so well? So a scientist actually looked at this in the domain of cockroaches, an unusual place to look at it. But he actually built a cockroach stadium. So imagine a little track where cockroaches could run cockroach races, and he could time how quickly the cockroaches ran those races. So imagine a little box that the doors opened on, a light is flashed in the box. Cockroaches hate light, as we all know. So the cockroach would run out of the box to the other dark end of the raceway, and that would be done, and the scientists would time how fast the cockroach ran. Well, in addition, he included cockroach stands. So imagine other cockroaches, not really watching, but literally next to the cockroach. So a box filled with other cockroaches. And he found that when this track was a straightaway, the cockroach ran faster. The fact that other cockroaches were around, similar to people, made the cockroach work faster and harder. But he had a theory about when others help and when others hurt. He thought that others might help when the task was easy, when it was simple, like running straight down a straightaway. But others might hurt when the task was more complicated or difficult. And we can think of the same thing with people, right? When we're tying our own shoes, that's an easy thing. Others might make us do it faster. But when something's difficult, like parallel parking or tying a bow tie, others might make us worse off. And so he used another type of track. Imagine a T-shaped track where the cockroach had to run straight, turn left or turn right, and then go to the end. Not just straight away, but had to make a decision along the way. And sure enough, he found that when other cockroaches were around, the cockroach ran slower, didn't finish the race as fast when it was complicated. And it turns out that since then, this has been replicated in dozens of other experiments. So if a task is easy, people and animals do it faster when others are around or others are watching them. But when it's something that we're not so good at, others around make us slower and do it worse. And so I think this has some really exciting and interesting implications for motivating ourselves and others. You know, if you're pretty good at running, for example, and you're trying to get better, well, running with someone else, or if you're good at swimming in a lane next to someone else will make you work a little harder. I was just at the pool yesterday, for example. I saw someone in the lane next to me, and it made me push a little harder. We've all had that good feeling where someone else makes us push harder and work harder. And so others can be a powerful motivating force. But if it's a case where we're not so good at something we're just learning, let's say you're just starting out as a runner or a swimmer, you're trying to learn something complicated, a complicated new recipe, or you know, you're trying to motivate people at work, maybe an open office plan isn't necessarily good, right? Maybe if they're doing complicated tasks, the fact that someone else is around might make them slower or less good at it. So others can be a powerful motivating force, but we need to think about when to use them and how to use them appropriately.
Yeah, I definitely feel a little awkward if I'm completing a task that I don't really know what I'm doing for, but if I do what I'm doing well, then I invite an audience. And so it kind of feeds the ego a little bit too. I think that's also a component of that factor as well.
It's funny. I picture being at the gym, you know, like you see the guys and something at the gym, and then like maybe you're new to the gym, but you're going to show up, and then you've got these other guys, you know, pumping the big iron and working next to you, and you have no idea what you're doing.
Yeah. So, Jonah, sorry we lost you for a second. We got him back on the phone, though. We've got about a couple of minutes left. Now, you're the author of Contagious, Why Things Catch On, and Invisible Influence, The Hidden Forces That Shape a Behavior. Tell us a little bit about what entrepreneurs can get from these books.
So, yeah, I think it's a powerful toolkit for entrepreneurs. You know, you don't have to have a big advertising budget, though having some advertising budget certainly helps. You don't have to have the best product out there. You just have to figure out how to generate word of mouth and how to use social influence to help you. And I think at the basic level, you know, the one simple takeaway is, how do I turn customers into advocates? Whether those customers are external, folks that like me already, or internal within an organization, how do I use these folks to help me grow my business and spread my ideas? And that's what the books will help you do. It'll help you think about how to generate word of mouth based on the science of why people talk and share, and how to increase your influence, how to get your ideas out there, how to change people's behavior by using the tools of influence to get your messages to be more popular.
All right. Well, good discussion, Jonah Berger. We greatly appreciate you checking in from up north there, and wish you a great, successful week.
Thank you. Thank you.
And again, Jonah Berger, marketing professor at the Wharton School at the University of Pennsylvania. He has advised a number of big businesses on the role of social influence in marketing. He's worked with Google, Facebook, a number of other big brands as well. So we're really grateful that we had him on the show today. Learn more about him, jonahberger.com. And again, be sure to pick up a copy of his books, Contagious and also Invisible Influence. And we'll put a link up to those on the recap over at Tampa Bay Radio blog.com. Also, a reminder, the upcoming awards show on January 23rd, tickets are still available for that. $59 for Tampa Bay business owner members and $69 for non-members. And our featured speaker will be Maya Kazajic, who is a Bosnian War survivor, motivational speaker, been featured on the show a couple times. So she will be our keynote speaker. And so pick up the tickets over at TampaBayRadio.com. And please connect with us all across social media. You can find us on Facebook at Facebook.com/ThatBusinessShow, and also on Twitter at ThatBizShow. And also pick up a copy of the new fall and winter edition of the Edge Business Magazine. Simply visit ThatBusinessMagazine.com, and you can also subscribe to the 6 annual issues for just $38. Again, visit ThatBusinessMagazine.com. And if you'd like to learn how to come onto the program, please visit TBSinterview.com. I hope everybody has a great week, and we'll see you back in here tomorrow morning on That Business Show with Jamie and Kelly, where business becomes show business.